right there. And let that blade thump on your finger. It doesn't smack the case, then you give it a jolt. Your finger acts as a shock absorber. And a blade like this will last forever. They're made to bend this way. Do not try to bend them the other way. That will kink the tape. It'll split the metal tape, and it'll give up real quick. Always bend them upwards. Sometimes it's a little funny trying to measure something up that way, but you can always measure around and stick your thumb on it and pick it up and read it, because measurements will be on the inside, not the outside. So that's one trick with a tape. It'll last you forever if you keep your finger under there and let it pump it. Measuring wood. Everybody gets their pencil. Everybody's got a pencil. There it is over here. Hang on. Everybody marks their wood with a pencil. They put a little line or a little arrow. That don't work in miniatures. In fact, it don't work trimming a house, putting the molding on the inside of a house. Pencil line is too wide, too thick. To mark a board for miniatures or inside trim, an X-Acto knife. You put the knife right on the measurement. You want to measure, say, up to here. And you put the knife right there and just push, and it gives a little mark in the wood, a little fine mark. That's where you cut it. And when you cut wood, don't cut it right on that mark. Here's your board. Here's your mark. A saw blade is about that wide. If you cut it straight on that mark, you're going to cut off some of the board that you need. Always put the saw blade to one side of that mark. This is the piece you need. That's the length you want. Cut this board right there. Then you got the length that you need right here. Like the new carpenter that was on the job, and he went to the boss and he says, "I don't understand it, boss. I cut that board 3 times and it's still too short." That's what he's doing. He's cutting into that mark. What else we got here? Ah, another carpenter trick for a corner. With a tape measure, you can find out if a corner is square. I should have had a rag here. Here's a corner. If you want to find out if this is 90 degrees or square, measure 3 inches this way, measure 5 inches this way, and it will measure 6 inches across there. If it's not 6 inches, it's not square. Nope, that's wrong. 3, 4, and 5 inches. Those are the numbers you got to remember. 3 inches this way, 4 inches that way, and it'll measure 5 inches here. 3, 4, and 5. Try to keep that in your head all the time. When we get our table built, we're going to get a sheet of plexiglass. When you get it all built, all the lines drawn, you get a sheet of plexiglass. Here's a piece here. And you lay it right on top of this table. That way, you can still see all the marks you put in there. And you can lay out everything on it, but the glue won't glue your work to the table. The glue won't glue to the plexiglass. Give me that bottle of food, Derek. Oh, it's the big bottle. This is the glue we use. It's Elmer's Carpenter's Wood Glue. There's two different kinds. There's Elmer's White Wood Glue, and there's Elmer's Carpenter Wood Glue. Get the Carpenter's Wood Glue. It's almost a yellow color. The white don't work near as good. That's for paper and cloth and other things. Get the yellow. It says in there it's got to be fair wood. Well, I've tested it with the stain on it. I stained a piece of wood, two pieces actually, and I glued them together and let them set overnight, and I come back the next morning and tried to pull it apart. Well, it didn't pull apart. The wood broke. So it will glue through the stain. I didn't think it would, but it surprised me. It works really good that way. Well, this is just the first section. The next part of this tape will be laying out floor joists. If you want to actually build a log cabin that's stick built like a regular house, get your plywood, get the table built, and we'll start framing up a little cabin.